Thank you for joining us today for our Walk of Honor dedication ceremony. I'm Michael House, Senior Vice President here at the National World War I Museum and Memorial. This is our country's National World War I Museum and Memorial, and it's wonderful that it's in Kansas City because of a fairly small group of people who literally 100 years ago raised more than $2.5 million in less than 2 weeks to build what became Liberty Memorial, the tower on top of the museum where we are now. This part of the museum and memorial opened in 2006, if you're not familiar with that recent history. So it's a remarkable story and a real credit to the citizens of Kansas City. So whether you live here or you're visiting, we're so glad that you're with us today. Our program will begin with the presentation of colors by the Knights of Columbus, fourth degree, Father Bernard J. Donnelly, Assembly 566, who are also dedicating a brick today, as many of you are. Please stand. Please join me in welcoming vocalist Casi Joy, who will sing the national anthem, and this will be followed by Rear Admiral J. Stanton Thompson, a member of the advisory board at the National World War I Museum and Memorial, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets ran glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free, in the
explain the uniform that I have on. It is an exact replica of the service dress blue uniform worn by naval officers in 1914. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Thank you, Admiral, and thank you, Casi, for that beautiful rendition of our national anthem. If you don't know Casi Joy yet, you will. You can learn more about her and her music at CassiJoy.com. The spelling of her name is on your program. Be sure to remember her name, remember her music. I hope you find interest in it, because in the not too distant future, she's going to be famous, and you're going to tell your friends and family, I saw her perform live at the National World War I Museum and Memorial, and they're not going to believe you. So enjoy. Enjoy her voice, and you will hear it again in just a little while. Thank you again for coming today to spend this part of your Memorial Day, a very important day to all of us here at the museum and memorial. We're so glad that you're here to work with us, to be with us, to honor those who have served our country and our community. The Walk of Honor has been such a meaningful program for so many people, and we hope it is for you too. We're so glad that you've chosen this way to honor and memorialize and remember your loved ones. Next, I'd like to introduce you to our speaker, Dr. Timothy Westcott. Dr. Westcott is Associate Professor of History, Associate University Archivist, and Director of the George S. Robb Center for the Study of the Great War at Park University. He has received numerous awards, including the Department of Defense's Patriot Award. Dr. Westcott has been a friend and supporter of the National World War I Museum and Memorial over the years, and helped establish the Edward Jones Research Center, which many of you are familiar with. Please welcome Dr. Timothy Westcott.
Thank you, Dr. House, Dr. Naylor, Rear Admiral Thompson, Sarah, and the staff here at the National World War I Museum and Memorial for this invitation. Thank you to everyone that is attending this special occasion. If this is your first visit to the museum and memorial, welcome. If you're returning to the museum and memorial, welcome back. A century ago this year, as Michael just mentioned, the Liberty Memorial Association and citizens of Kansas City raised more than $2.5 million in just 10 days, equivalent to $34 million today, to construct the beginnings of the best museum, if not memorial, to honor those that served and died during the 1,500 days of the Great War. But I also advocate, as a United States Marine, that this museum and memorial honors those that served and paid the ultimate sacrifice since 1919, and continues to honor those that serve in the United States Armed Forces today. If you are a veteran or on current military duty, would you please rise? Thank you. 2 years later, in 1921, more than 100,000 people gathered to see the Supreme Allied Commanders dedicate this site. 5 years later, during the dedication ceremony in 1926, President Calvin Coolidge remarked, quote, "It," meaning the Liberty Memorial, "has not been raised to commemorate war and victory, but rather the results of war and victory, which are embodied in peace and liberty," end quote. I have been honored for approximately 30 years to be associated with this museum and memorial, and its outstanding staff and leaders that fulfill Coolidge's remarks daily. I remember 25 years ago, due to safety concerns, the physical structure of this site being closed. Those were dark days. Thousands of feet of chain link fence, years of wondering, struggles of fundraising, and the turmoil of politics. However, the dedication of numerous individuals, foundations, and corporations have and continue to endorse and validate the vision of those civic leaders of a century ago. We all are so blessed for their sustained leadership and support. Former President Bill Clinton recently remarked that, quote, "Everyone has a story, and everyone's story has value," end quote. There is a glass bridge, sort of right out the door, that overlooks 9,000 poppies, representing the 9 million combatant fatalities of the Great War. We are called here today to remember that each of those 9 million sons, husbands, fathers, brothers, and uncles had a story of value. The veterans from the Great War, World War II, Pearl Harbor, Vietnam, Korea, Afghanistan, Desert Storm, current service personnel, and others gathered here today, when you walk across that bridge, a bridge of transitional passage, also have a story or stories of value which we honor this Memorial Day. Historian Jay Winter has written, quote, "Millions died, but to say so was merely to begin, not to conclude the search for the meaning," end quote. This day, referred to as Memorial Day and as a federal holiday, is officially only 48 years young. Originally known as Decoration Day, and some of us in this room do remember that phrase, the day originated in the years following the Civil War. Congress in 1968 passed the Uniform Monday Holiday Act, which established Memorial Day as the last Monday in May in order to create a three-day weekend for federal employees. Though we may enjoy the pleasure of a three-day weekend, as a nation, we continue to struggle for the meaning, compassion, and understanding regarding memorialization as recent national events challenge us. I take a few moments here to reflect on three fundamentals in which individuals and nations search for that meaning. Number one, bereavement. Suffering the death, usually of a loved one. The state of being bereaved usually occurs in the immediate aftermath or notification of death. Individuals seek solace with family, friends, and others. Nations pursue understanding as larger communities, as we remember, following 9/11. Eventually, the immediate period of bereavement wavers. Individuals continue their lives while nations move on to other affairs. Number two, remembrance, to celebrate or honor the memory of a person or event. The state of celebration or honor for individuals occur on those special days, birthdays, anniversaries, graduations, while a nation remembers on an annual or specific numerical year. For example, our remembrance next week of the 75th anniversary of the D-Day landings, or the recent centennial marking the end of hostilities of the Great War. Number three, commemoration. The act or occasion marked by observances that remind one of the origin and significance of an event. The act of commemorating not only engages the two previous fundamentals, but usually invokes memorialization by granite, marble, concrete. These memorializations are to endure for future generations to reflect and understand. Today, as individuals and families, loved ones, you will experience all three fundamentals: bereavement, remembrance, commemoration, as we all memorialize your particular granite brick, along with the over 11,000 others in the Walk of Honor. Our meeting here today brings focus to featured loved ones to be honored. However, the search for meaning continues relevant to our national participation and understanding in the Great War. Historian Richard Slutkin has written, quote, "The myths of a nation or a community are the stories that embody the memory of their people's collective past, an act of historical justice to veterans. But it is also worth recovering for the sake of justice itself. It is one of those stories that reminds us just how difficult it has been for America to live up to the promises of liberty and justice for all that were made at the nation's birth," end quote. Recently, students and myself from our program of history has undertaken, in association with the World War I Centennial Commission, the United States Foundation for the Commemoration of the World Wars, the American Legion, and the Veterans History Veterans of Foreign Wars, the Valor Medal Review Project. The project is conducting a systematic investigation into African American, Asian American, Hispanic American, Jewish American, and Native American veterans of the Great War who, in spite of deserving deeds, may have been unjustly denied high-level valor awards owing to the circumstances of their birth. In particular, service members worthy of a Medal of Honor who may have been downgraded to a Distinguished Service Cross or received no American recognition at all despite receiving a French Croix de Guerre with palm or actually having a Medal of Honor recommendation submitted. When speaking with daughters, granddaughters, grandsons, or other descendants of these veterans, all three fundamentals are embedded in our conversations. Weeping at the fact that someone cares about these forgotten veterans. Forwarding of photographs and letters of their beloved veterans. And just the possibility that our nation may ultimately acknowledge these veterans' acts of valor. Stories are told of their loved ones being killed on the Meuse-Argonne battlefield or arriving home physically and mentally shattered. Or those stories of value never told. Carrying out this project requires exactly what victory in the Great War did, the contributions of Americans from all backgrounds. As this project looks back over a century, so as not to forget, we as a nation owe our current veterans and service personnel, quote, acts of historical justice, end quote, the duty to address the over 8,000 veterans that commit suicide annually, and the approximately 38,000 homeless veterans, lest we forget. We meet here today as a community of the bereaved that remember and commemorate, no matter which century, decade, year, month, week, or day, nor race, or religion. We memorialize those that served at the highest standards of valor. William Shakespeare, writing in 1598, furnishes a fitting stanza of military solace. Quote, "From this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers. For he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother. Be he never so vile, this day shall gentle his condition," end quote. As we prepare to honor those here today with a granite brick, I conclude by reminding those loved ones and all of us that overseeing the walk of honor outside are four guardian spirits: courage, honor, patriotism, and sacrifice. Guardian spirits for our and future generations. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim. Please join me now for a moment of silence. Now we will dedicate the 2019 Memorial Day Walk of Honor bricks. Please be sure your cell phones are silenced.
Took my love and I took it down.
I climb the mountain and I turn around. And if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hill where the landslide brought me down, oh, mirror in the sky, what is love? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I handle the changing ocean tide? Can I handle the seasons of my life? I don't know. Time makes you bolder, children get older, and I'm getting older too. So take this love, take it down. Oh, if you climb a mountain and you turn around, and if you see reflection in the snow-covered hill where the landslide brought me down. And if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hill, well, maybe told me when I was young, come sit beside me, my only son, and listen closely to what I say. And if you do this, it'll help you some sunny day. Oh, take your time, don't live too fast. Troubles will come and they will pass. We'll find a woman and you'll find love. And don't forget, son, there is someone. Forget your lust for the rich man's gold, all that you need now. This world should have burned down a long time ago. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. To believe in this living is just a hard way to go. When I was a young girl, I had me cowboy. He wasn't much to look at, just a freeway on a land. That was a long time. No matter how I tried, his dreams come back like a broken down dam. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. To believe in this living is just a hard way to go. There's flies in the kitchen. I can hear them buzzing, but I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. How the hell can a person go to work in the morning and come home in the evening and they got nothing to say? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the battle king opposing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Faith was strong when she needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throat and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. 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 God above, but all I've ever learned from love is how to shoot at someone who outdrew you. When it's not a cry that you hear at night, it's not someone who's seen the light, it's a call and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Thank you again, Casi. We are so incredibly fortunate to live in the United States of America, and it's because of the men and women honored today and many others. Let's be sure to honor them not only today on Memorial Day, but every year, year after year, forever, for all they did for us so that we could live here as we do. I'd like for you to meet, if you haven't already, one of my colleagues, Sarah Foltz. Sarah is in charge of the Walk of Honor program, and I'd like for you to see who she is in case you've only emailed her or spoken with her on the telephone, and give her a chance to say hello.
Thank you all for coming today. I have been honored to hear your stories and learn about all of these incredible people. I would love to keep talking to you. Don't think that this is the end of our communications. I will be out on the Walk of Honor after this, but thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sarah. Please be sure to come back and see us. Remember, this is your National World War I Museum and Memorial, including the grounds. We want you to come here. Of course, we'd like for you to buy a ticket, but you don't have to every time. Come back and visit. The most wonderful view of Kansas City is from the Memorial Courtyard on top. Some of you were out there earlier today. From Father's Day, every evening that week thereafter, we have something called Taps at the Tower. It's short but meaningful and so wonderful. It's at sunset. Just show up one or more of those nights. You can even bring your dog if you'd like, and bring your kids, bring everybody, and enjoy that short but wonderful ceremony. And then you can see the lights turn on in the big buildings downtown from the courtyard. You can see a nice sunset many nights. The weather usually is really good that particular week of Father's Day. And we'd love for you to come back. But anytime, come back. Bring a picnic lunch and a blanket and spread it out wherever you want in any of the grassy areas on this beautiful 47-acre park. Enjoy all of it, the outside, the inside, Memorial Courtyard on the top. It's all there for you to enjoy every day of the year. The only days we aren't open are major holidays and then Mondays through Labor Day, from Labor Day through Memorial Day. But you can come and be here on the outside and on the courtyard just about any time that you like. As you leave the auditorium today, please go forward with peace and remembrance in your heart and in your mind. Thank you again for being here with us on Memorial Day. Good afternoon.